The next initiative is the spoken tutorial. The spoken tutorial project is initiated after the talk to a teacher activity under Anime ICT, launched by MHRD, Government of India. Spoken Tutorial is a multi-award winning educational content portal. Here, one can learn various free and open source software all by oneself. Self-paced, multilingual courses ensure that anybody with a computer and a desire to learn can learn from any place, at any time, and in a language of their own choice. All the content published on this website are shared under the open license policy, and we will discuss this license in the coming modules. The next initiative is the virtual classroom, which is AVIEW, Amrita Virtual Interactive E-Learning World. It is also an award-winning, indigenously developed and built multimodal multimedia e-learn platform that provides an immersive e-learning experience that is almost as good as a real classroom experience developed by Amrita E-Learning Research Lab. AVIEW is a part of Talk to a Teacher program coordinated IIT Bombay that we already discussed, and it is funded by MHRD under Anime ICT, along with various other projects in virtual labs, haptics and natural language processing. AVIEW is now deployed at all several IIT, NIITs and other leading educational institutions across the nation. Now, let's discuss the one of the best initiative of the Government of India at present time, that is SWAYAM, Study Web of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. SWAYAM is a program initiated by Government of India and designed to achieve three cardinal principles of education policy that we already discussed: assess, equity and quality. The objective of this effort is to take the best teaching learning resources to all, including the most disadvantaged persons. SWAYAM seeks to bridge the digital divide for students who have hitherto remain untouched by the digital revolution and have not been able to join the mainstream of the knowledge economy. This is done through a platform that facilitates hosting of all courses taught in classroom right from class 9th till post-graduation to be assessed by anyone, anywhere, at any time. All the courses are interactive, prepared by the best teacher in the country, and are available free of cost to any learner. More than 1,000 specially chosen faculty and teachers from across the country have participated in preparing these courses. The courses which are hosted on SWAYAM are in four quadrant approach. The first is a video lecture. The second, specially prepared reading material that can be downloaded and printed. The third one is a self-assessment through test and quizzes. And the fourth one, online discussion forum for clearing the doubts. Apart from this, the web links to study more will also be provided. Steps have been taken to enrich the learning experience while using audio, video and multimedia and state-of-the-art pedagogy and technology. In order to ensure that best quality content is produced and delivered, 9 national coordinators have been appointed. They are, the first one is the AICT, All India Council for Technical Education. They are dealing with self-paced courses and the international courses. Say, for example, if any faculty from the foreign university is willing to launch his or her courses on SWAYAM, it will be facilitated by AICTE. The second is NPTEL, National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. NPTEL is taking care of the courses referring to graduate and postgraduate from engineering streams. The next one is the University Grants Commission, that is UGC. UGC has to develop the postgraduate non-technical courses. Then Consortium for Educational Communication, that is CEC. CEC is developing the course for undergraduate non-technical streams. And then NCERT, National Council of Education Research and Training, they are dealing with the school education. The course is from 9 to 12 class. And then NIS, they have their own structure of class 10 and 12, and they are developing the course for the same. IGNU is developing the diploma and certificate courses. Indian Institute of Management, that is Bangalore, they are dealing the courses from the management. And then National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research, they are dealing with the technical training courses for teachers. Courses delivered through SWAYAM are available free of cost to the learners. However, learners wanting a SWAYAM certificate should register for the final proctor exam that come at a fee and attend in person at designated centers on specified dates. Eligibility for the certificate will be announced at the time on the course page. And learners will get certificates only if this criteria is matched. University or colleges approving credit transfer for these courses can use the marks or certificate obtained in these courses from the same. The next initiative of Government of India is the SWAYAM Prabha. The SWAYAM Prabha is a group of 32 DTS channels devoted to telecasting of high quality educational programs on 24/7 being using the GSAT-15 satellite. Every day there will be a new content for at least 4 hours, which would be repeated by 5 more times in a day, allowing the students to choose the time of their convenience. The channels are uplinked from Vizag Gandhinagar. The contents are provided by NPTEL, IITs, UGC, CEC, IGNU, NCERT and NIS, that is National Institute of Open Schooling. The InfleepNet Center maintains the web portal. The DTS channels covers the following. The first one, from the higher education, which is curriculum based courses content at postgraduate and undergraduate level covering diverse disciplines such as arts, science, commerce, performing arts, social sciences and humanities, engineering, technology, law, medicine, agriculture, etc. All courses would be certification ready in their detailed offering through SWAYAM portal being developed for offering MOOC courses. The next one, for the school education, that is from 9 to 12 level. Modules for teachers training as well as teaching and learning aids for children of India to help them understand the subject better and also help them in preparing for competitive examination for admissions to professional degree programs. The next, curriculum based courses that can meet the needs of lifelong learners of the citizens of India and abroad also. The next one, assist students especially from class 12th and 11th, those who are preparing for competitive exams. The next initiative of the MHRD for higher education is the National Digital Library. Ministry of Human Resource Development under NMEICT has initiated the National Digital Library of India pilot project to develop a framework of virtual repositories of learning resources with a single window search facility. Filtered and federated searching is employed to facilitate focused searching so that learners can find out the right resource with least effort in minimum time. NDL India is designed to hold content of any language and provide interface support for leading Indian languages. It is being arranged to provide support for all academic levels, including researchers and lifelong learners in all disciplines and all popular form of access devices and differently abled learners. It is being developed to help students to prepare for entrance and competitive examination. To enable people to learn and prepare from best practices from all across the world and to facilitate researchers to perform interlinked exploration from multiple sources. This pilot project is devising a framework that is being scaled up with respect to content volume and diversity to serve all levels and discipline of learners. It is being developed at IIT Kharagpur. The National Academic Depository. The vision of National Academic Depository is born out of an initiative to provide an online storehouse of all academic awards. National Academic Depository, which is NAD, is 24/7 online storehouse of all academic awards that includes the certificates, diplomas, degrees, mark sheets, etc. Duly digitized and logged by academic institutions provided by the different boards, eligibility assessment and bodies. NAD not only ensure easy access to retrieval of an academic award, what also validates and guarantees its authenticity and safe storage. National Academic Depository comprises of two interoperable digital depositories, that is CDSL Ventures Limited and NSDL Database Management Limited. These digital depositories have ensured hardware, network facilities and software of prescribed quality for smooth and secure operationalization of NAD.